Welcome to Professor Mad. Let's explore the fascinating realms of mathematics. Today, we embark on a journey to uncover the mysterious connection between circles and a special number called pi, symbolized by the Greek letter. Let's consider several circles with different diameters, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeters, and 3 centimeters. We can measure the circumference of each circle. If we divide the measured circumference by its diameter, something interesting happens. We always get a special number, around 3.14. Isn't that amazing? For any circle, the ratio between circumference and diameter is around 3.14. This amazing discovery has been known since ancient times. Different civilizations like the Babylonians, Egyptians, Greeks, and Indians independently found approximations for this special ratio, showing their curiosity about circles. Throughout history, mathematicians have devised ingenious methods to approximate the value of this ratio. For ease of representation, they began using the Greek letter pi for this ratio in the 1700s. That's how this number got its name. So pi is the ratio between circumference and diameter of a circle. In simpler terms, pi represents how many times the diameter of a circle can fit into its circumference. This value is approximately equal to 3.14. To go further, we need to know the rational numbers and irrational numbers. Numbers that can be written as a simple ratio of two whole numbers are called rational numbers. But there's another type of number called irrational numbers, which cannot be expressed as a fraction of whole numbers. Whole numbers, finite decimals, and recurring decimals are all rational numbers. Irrational numbers are non-terminating and non-recurring decimals. When it comes to circles, there is another interesting fact that we must know. When we consider the diameter and circumference, either the diameter or the circumference, or sometimes both, must be irrational numbers. Both cannot be rational at the same time. When we divide an irrational number by a rational number, or vice versa, the result is always an irrational number. So because the ratio of circumference to diameter is an irrational number, pi itself is an irrational number. That means, unlike rational numbers, pi cannot be expressed precisely as a finite fraction or terminating decimal. Its decimal representation extends infinitely without repeating patterns, making it an irrational number. But there are many rational approximations to the value of pi. Most popular one is 22 divided by 7. It gives the value of pi equal to 3.14159. It's not exactly the value of pi, but that approximation is enough for us to use in most of our calculations. Throughout history, mathematicians developed numerous techniques to approximate the value of pi. Mathematicians refined these approximations, pushing the boundaries of precision. Even now, the value of pi continues to be further unraveled up to and beyond its 50 trillionth digit. Mathematicians are still searching for possible patterns within pi if its digits should ever begin to repeat. However, even if no pattern is ever found, calculating the value of pi is still valuable for the development of computer programs. Every year on March 14th, math enthusiasts around the world celebrate Pi Day. The date corresponds to the first 3 digits of pi, 3.14. It's a day filled with math activities, pi recitation competitions, and of course, indulging in some delicious circular pies. Stay curious and keep exploring. Like and subscribe us for more interesting videos.